Just after 2 minutes.
1 second. So today we are going to see Spring Security. Okay. And also before going for Spring Security, so far what we did is we did all the configuration and all the like, for example, if you want to connect with the database, we have created a hibernate.cfg.xml file. Similarly, some beans can be configured in Spring config file kind of thing. And everything is a XML file. But what we are going to do today is we are not going to use any XML file. Instead, we are going to use a Java file. Okay. So when we use a Java file, like the code will be very precise and it will be very easy to do. And now, like plenty of the programmers, they instead of going for the XML file, they will go for this kind of Java file alone. Okay.
Okay.
So first thing is we just created a basic structure. Okay, well, basic structure of Spring, and first we have to add all the dependencies. Okay. So first you make sure that we are going to upload it in the Tomcat. So you have to put the packaging as var file after version. Okay. We should start adding the dependencies. So first you add dependencies. Okay. So first you create the first dependency as first you create a first dependency. The group ID is org.springframework. Okay. And the artifact is WebMVC. You just type WebMVC. You just select that. Okay. So you can take any release of 5. Okay. Then the second dependency is the servlet. So the dependency is JavaX. The group ID is javax.servlet. javax.servlet. And the artifact is javax.servlet. servlet-api. Yeah. The first one. Yeah. Then we have to add for a JSP support, we have to add one more thing, javax.servlet.jsp. Okay. And again, javax.servlet JSP API like that. Yeah. Second option. Yeah. Then you select any thing. And the next one is for a JSP tag libraries, we have to use one more thing. So one more dependency. So again, it comes from javax.servlet. Okay. So javax.servlet. And you just type JSTL. JSTL. Yeah. Select that. And the version you can take 1.2. So this is normal, right?
Right.
Okay. So now, what we are going to do is before going for Spring Security, we are first going to convert all the XML configuration into a Java file configuration.
Okay.
So normally in Java file, what are all the classes we will create? We will create entity, right?
Right.
Entity. After that, what we will create?
Controller
kind of thing. Right?
Yeah, sure.
So then we can have DAO classes, DAO thing. Then we have services, repositories will be there, like that kind of thing. It will go. Now what you do is inside the Java folder, you create one folder called config.
Okay.
Yeah. Before that, you create a package right click and you create some package like org dot, like spring.security, yeah, security like that. Okay, select okay. Yeah, then now the package is created. Okay, now inside the package you create one class called inside a package you create another class with a package called config. Okay, you just type config dot. Okay, the first config is app config. APP, yeah, config. Yeah. So now in app config, what we will do is normally what you will do in Spring configuration file.
In Spring configuration file, we are just telling about spring.configuration.xml file. We are just telling about the frontend controller path and the base path for our controller, from where the request will be comes and all those.
That I think we'll use in web.xml, right?
Web.xml. Okay. I just forgot. Yeah.
Okay. So in app, you just go and open that. Open some project and we will explore it so that you will understand. I think there is recent. You can select file recent. Okay. Fine. New window. Yeah. So go to a Spring configuration file. You just tell me what are all the things we will do here.
The first things we are telling about.
Starts with line number 6. Yeah,
sure. First of all, we are just telling about the component scanning. If I am saying like I am put the annotation on controller and some entities and all those, from where it need to start. If the first request will come, that will
okay.
be.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, that is the first thing. Because
the first request will be come to the controller and all those that we are telling here. So now suppose I am using some in controller where our request will be goes to which JSP page that we are telling about here. From which folder it will be started. That is by the suffix and the prefix.
The same thing we are going to do in Java file. Okay, you minimize this. Go there.
Okay.
So what kind of a file this is, app config? By the name itself, you can say what kind of file.
So it will be telling about the configuration of a particular application.
So there is annotation in line number 2, you can put at configuration. This specifies that this is the
configuration
file. Yeah, second one.
Okay.
And we have to, since we are going to do like MVC, like we are in MVC, we can have JSP, we can have a controller, we can have a backend kind of thing. So since this application is a web MVC configuration, this application is a Spring MVC, we have to we have to make sure that the whole application is enabled with MVC. So there is annotation called at enable web MVC. At enable web MVC. Yeah. So this will tell that we are going to use a web MVC. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. That means we are going to use Spring MVC.
Okay. So if I had compared this enable web MVC configuration with our previous Spring security, the previous Spring configuration, so it's something like this one part.
This at enable web MVC, which will replace this web.xml, because in web.xml you will have a dispatcher servlet kind of thing, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, so that this will replace with the help of the single line. So at enable web MVC, because here you are specifying there will be a dispatcher, and also I think like it will replace both, right? Web.xml as well as spring-configuration.xml, because I will just tell you how it works. Okay. So just minimize there, and which is missing, which one we have to add?
Which one I had to add in pens?
You compare the previous one. So we have added the configuration, right? Because we have added web MVC also. This will replace web.xml. And which one we have to add? You just tell me. We have we just converted web.xml to at enable web MVC. Okay, we have make sure that this application is a this file is a configuration file.
So I thought the spring configuration XML file is left.
Yeah, inside that, which one is left?
Just a minute. Which one is left? This one. Prefix and suffix.
Prefix and suffix is missing, and also the component scan is missing.
Component scanning.
Okay. So there is an annotation called. Go to the code. There is an annotation called at configure at component scan.
Okay.
And then you have to pass the value here. In that XML file, what you will pass?
The base path. I mean, like this one. After the Java, the package that we are going.
Yeah. So what is that actually?
It's org.spring.sec.
No. The path is org.spring.security. What is that thing? What is that actually? It's a base
path. I mean base package.
Yeah, you type there. Component scan base package equal to.
Okay. Default.
Double quotes equal to. org.spring.security. Spring.security. That's enough.
Why it's not showing?
No, it won't show because we are putting in double quotes, right? It should be in double quotes. So I'm telling you that if we put that in double quotes, it won't show the suggestion.
So if I just remove all those double quotes, then it will be showing me?
No, it won't show because like this is the value, right? So it won't show. You just delete that config. Just put that double quotes, yeah. Because the config will be a separate folder.
Fine.
Yeah. So now tell me which one is missing.
The JSP configuration. I mean the prefix.
Yeah. So for the JSP, up to this you can able to understand?
Yeah, sure.
So now for the JSP, we have to specify like a set prefix, set suffix like that, right? But there is no annotation for that. We have to write a bean, separate bean method.
Okay,
go inside the app config. Okay. Then you type public method name, public space view resolver. In capital V because it's a class name. View resolver. Select. Space. You just give some object method name. View resolver like that. Yeah. You select that. Okay. Just close that. Open parenthesis and close parenthesis. Yeah. Open curly bracket. Yeah. Enter. Now, actually, this method here inside this method, we will specify like what view resolver we are going to use. What view resolver we will use in a Spring config file?
I think it's internal something like that.
Yeah. You just go there, copy that and you paste it. There
internal
is a class. Yeah. You type here. Internal resource view resolver. Internal, select that. Internal, yeah, space, give some object name, yeah, equal to new internal view resolver. Okay, yeah, put a semicolon. Now using this object, yeah, just put dot, then you type set prefix, right? So what is the prefix, what is the path actually, where our JSP file is there?
Inside the JSP package slash web app.
So just put double quotes. You copy the same thing and you can paste in value.
It's in double quotes.
Yeah, double quotes. slash, yeah, correct. INF slash, yeah. Yeah. Then which one is missing? Which is the second one?
Suffix.
Yeah. So dot set suffix. Yeah.
JSP?
Yeah, dot JSP. Now you have to return the object, right? Because we are returning the class view resolver. View resolver is a base class for the internal resource view resolver.
Okay.
So return internal view resolver.
Okay.
That's it. So this is how we will replace our existing Spring config file.
Okay.
Okay. Like I said, we need to look an alternative for web.xml also, right?
Right.
So web.xml, the one thing we have to do is first we have to enable web MVC here. So we did that. So one more file we have to create.
Okay.
So what is the name of the file we can create for that particular thing?
Hyper.cfg.xml.
No. this app config will replace spring-config.xml. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now we are going to replace web.xml.
Okay.
What is the class name we can give? What this web.xml will do? You just go there and just see what this web.xml will do.
Dispatcher servlets will be telling about in the URL pattern.
Yeah. So we can name that as dispatcher, right?
Dispatcher, yeah.
Yeah, so go there.
Okay.
Go there and you can name that as right click and you create a new class like dispatcher kind of thing, or you can put like dispatcher config like that, because I think already dispatcher class is there. Okay.
Yeah.
So now we have to make sure that we have to replace the web.xml. Okay.
Okay.
And for actually the dispatcher servlet is located in a predefined class called, there is one class. That class must be extends with this class called dispatcher config.
Okay.
So to use the dispatcher servlet, we have to extend this class with one class name. Okay. So what you public class dispatcher config extends. There is one thing called abstract annotation. Yeah. Config dispatcher servlet initializer. Okay. So if you extend that, we have to implement some methods. So these are the methods we have to implement. The first method is the root class. So we don't have any root class, but here it specifies that class 0. So you can simply put a return null.
So what does mean a root config class?
No, actually the root config class we have to specify. For example in web.xml there will be like some welcome servlet kind of thing, right?
Okay, right.
So that kind of welcome kind of thing you can specify, but here there is no welcome kind of thing. You can put that as null. Okay.
Okay.
And the second specifies the configuration of the servlet configuration class. So already we have specified the configuration file. What is the name of that configuration file we already written?
It's appconfig.
Yeah. So instead of the second zero, you put that as appconfig.class.
Here itself.
Yeah. New class. Just put new class. Just put Control Z.
Okay. New class.
Yeah, class of. Okay. No, not this of. The open square bracket, close square bracket. Then open curly bracket. Then after that, open curly bracket. After, yeah. Now he have to specify appconfig.class. Yeah, dot class. Okay. So here we are specifying what is the, here we are just specifying the string config thing. Okay. And the third one is, normally just go to the previous another project, that web.xml project. So where you will map actually, where is the URL pattern? What is the URL pattern you will use?
Slash and the base bar.
Yeah. Okay. Can you able to understand that? Because you see at the param value you put web-slash config dot spring hyphen configuration dot xml. Can you just tell me what is the equivalent of the Java file?
Can you repeat your question again?
So this is XML file, right?
Right.
And how we are relating that to a Java file?
Okay, we are just using appconfig to replace.
Yeah. Exactly. So this dispatcher, how we are creating dispatcher servlet?
Okay, so we are creating a dispatcher config file for wap.xml.
No, I'm asking is, here you are using org.springframework.web.servlet.dispatcher-servlet, right?
So we are using a dispatcher config. We are just extended with the abstract something.
Yeah. So that abstract annotation config dispatcher servlet initializer will replace this dispatcher servlet, okay? So the URL pattern is still missing, right?
Right. But one more thing I thought is missing, that these things like params and the params value, where we have
param value we specified, right? That appconfig.class.
Okay, that much. Okay.
And the param name it will automatically take.
Okay.
Then after that, just go to line number, go in the Java file. Now you replay, you just delete the zero there in 15, line number 15. Line number 15, you just delete zero alone. Yeah.
Zero alone.
Yeah. Then open curly bracket. So now just put a double quotes forward slash. Yeah, that's it. So this is actually a URL pattern of web.xml.
Okay.
Now that's it. So we just converted the XML file into this Java file, pure Java file.
Okay.
Can you able to understand now?
Yeah, sure. It's understood.
Okay. So now we didn't actually start with security. Okay. So can we just create some small MVC application before that? So to check whether we have replaced all the XML file with the Java file like that.
So I had one question before that.
Yeah.
Why we are doing all those things? Why we are doing all those things? Like we are just converting all those configuration and all those files to our annotation base. Why?
Actually, in what happened is, suppose for example, in some cases, like you will have plenty of view resolvers. For example, if you want to display, if you want to display some data in the form of PDF, okay, we have to use some other resolver.
Okay. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah. For that, if you use a older XML kind of thing, we have to write each and every resolver. We have to write a separate thing, like internal view resolver 1, internal view resolver 2, like that, each and everything we have to do. But here, instead of doing that, we will use that in method, instead of doing that, we can just create a Java method. And I forgot to add, go to the app config. So we have to make sure that this view resolver is a bean bean method. So you have to add annotation called at bean before this line number 14. Okay, that's it. So now what you do is we will create a simple controller that fetches the value from, for example, you have to create a JSP file that you have to type what is your name like that. When you type the name, it should go to the controller and it should return your name in another JSP file. Can we do that?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, do.
Shall I create a package for controller?
Yeah, yeah. But if you do that, it will show you configure dot controller like that. So what you can do is
you Java class file.
Just yeah, yeah, yeah. Like for example, home controller like that. And one more thing, you have to the base package is actually org.spring.security, right? It's showing config also. What you do is right click the thing.
Where? Yeah.
No, on the package. The package.
Okay.
Yeah. Right click. No, no, not here. Above.
Mm-hmm.
No, no. Java. Below that. Below that. Yeah. No, no. Yeah. Right click and new class. Config dot sample like that. Sample. Yes, should be caps. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Now you move app config and dispatcher config inside sample.
Yeah, sure.
This looks good. Okay, now you change the package name as like org.spring. Security.config like that. But you just don't change here. There you change the package name.
Sorry.
You just delete the config. Yeah. Right click and
rename. Yeah. No.
Yeah. Yeah. Refactor. Yeah. Rename. Yeah, delete that. This looks good. Yeah, refactor. Now it's fine, right? So security, okay. Config, okay, fine. So now, okay, so do that.
अरुल आ चुके हैं। हेलो
हेलो हेलो हेलो हेलो
आर यू देयर?
या या आई एम हियर, कैन यू हियर मी?
या श्योर।
एक्चुअली माय हेडसेट इज सम प्रॉब्लम सो इट्स डिस्कनेक्टेड।
Arul,
Yeah.
tell me one thing. I am just returning here the JSP name and
Yeah.
I'm taking its hair also, shipping, security. So tell me your requirement, what do you want to do?
Okay, but before that, go to controller.
Mm-hmm.
You have to add one more thing, right? A request
what?
Mapping for.
Request mapping is already there. No?
Okay, so.
Okay, okay, for method itself.
Yeah. Just a forward slash, that's enough. Yeah, okay.
Mm.
Okay, so it's correct only. Now what you have to do is you create this thing. Go to springsecurity.jsp.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now you have to create a form, right? Form
take these all those things.
What?
Nothing. I mean, to take all those things like form and all those. I mean, just enter the name and just to took and all those.
Yeah. For that, you have to create form. That's it. Form action. You have to put some slash process like that. Process? Yeah. So we are going to write a request mapping called process. Okay. So now you just type enter your name.
Enter topic.
Okay. Input type equal to text. Just give some name as topic. Okay. Then you create a submit button. Input type equal to submit. Yeah. That's enough.
Mm.
Okay. Now go to the home controller. Yeah, you have to write a mapping for process. Process and also you have to write request mapping. Okay.
Hmm.
So now how will you fetch the value from HTML?
I think inside the request params.
Yeah. Request param, you have to give the name also.
Mm.
Name equal to like that something. No, not here. Inside the
brackets.
Name equal to small n. Yeah. Name equal to what is the name? It's topic, right?
Mm.
Yeah. Double quotes topic. Okay. Then you have to create a variable. String topic like that. Okay. Now, how will you pass this to
model attribute? I thought model something like that.
Yeah, model, but there you have to pass the model, right? Model. There you have to, not model attribute, it's a model. There you have to pass the model in a param.
Okay. Here itself?
Yeah. It's not mod, it's model. Yeah. Model, then object, right? You are sleeping, I think.
No.
Okay, then yeah,
tell me something.
Topic, that's it, comma topic, that's it,
same name.
Okay,
then
you have to return the maybe like display.jsp, so you can put display here.
Display is not there. I thought I need to create it again.
Yeah, you have to create display.jsp, right? So in display, you have to just print it.
Dollar and all those?
Yeah, that's it. You just use, what is the name? It's a topic, right? Yeah, that's it. That's it. So now try to run this. We'll just check whether it's working or not. So hereafter, there won't be any configuration file, okay? We will use this kind of thing. Okay or not okay?
It's okay.
Okay, just delete that. Yeah. Good. Okay, apply. Okay. Yeah, give okay. That's it. Run this.
It's saying it's obsolete.
What?
Showing there's some warning. I don't
know. It says that Java 1.5 is obsolete.
So where we are using Java 1.5?
No, it's just it is just telling, that's it.
What was the part?
I think it's
why it's creating separate. I thought I just discussed it.
Minimize this one.
I think it's display.
Yeah.
As expected.
I think go to the no, not here. Go to the app config. You have to put a forward slash after JSP, right? There. Yeah, now it will work. It will work like charm. Yeah. So it's working, right? So which is easy, configuration file or this one?
Both are the same for me.
Both are same, but nowadays if you in the interview they will ask like how will you replace the XML file into a Java file like that. Okay.
Okay. Hello. So I had some doubts.
Yeah.
Should we discuss?
Yeah. Tell me.
Oh yeah. As we had discussed, why we are going to annotation? I mean, the Java class file instead of annotation, because the first drawback is like in case of if we are talking about suppose we are using a separate annotation, suppose. Instead of the JSP, we are using some PDF format and all those. We need to create a separate view resolver for that.
Yeah. Separate view resolver inside spring-config file.
Yeah. So similarly, here we also create now because in Java file itself, app config.java, we had created now.
Yeah. You should create a separate method. But the thing is, there will be like easy, like there will be a flexibility in the code, but for example, if you make all the configuration in XML file, it will be like each and every code will be in the separate thing. But here, if you do like that, it will be in a same like in the if all the configuration file will be placed in the same file rather than putting in a very long configuration file. And also execution wise, this will be faster because what configuration file it will do is it will just it is actually a file, right? You see in XML file it is actually a file. How you are reading that XML file?
By the text and all those.
Yeah, how will you just because we have to use spring-config.xml. It is actually a file, so. Actually, that file will execute internally all the Java things. The first thing it will just scan the file, and it will make sure that, for example, you just go to the window, that window.
Yeah, sure.
First, what it will do here is it will just go to the web.xml file. It will just allocate the dispatcher, right? So go to the web.xml. So it will allocate the dispatcher servlet. What is this dispatcher servlet is actually?
This
is a class, Java class, right? So again, this file is calling the Java class. Instead of this file is calling the Java class, why can't we directly write a Java class which do everything? Right? So this is this executes faster. The Java kind of configuration executes faster than XML.
Okay.
Then you just go to spring-configuration.xml.
So how you are knowing that like Java file will be running faster than configuration file?
Because you see this configuration file, first the application will scan this XML. That is the first step. Okay. For example, if it will just go to the seventh line and it will execute the XML file, that bean class. It will search for the bean class called internal resource view resolver. Then it will just check for the method called prefix. Okay. Like get prefix and get suffix like that. And it will assign the value.
So same case is happening also.
But
yeah,
we are directly doing in Java, right? It will first we are avoiding scanning the XML file, and we are actually this XML file at the background, it will do everything in a Java actually.
Okay.
So instead of taking this XML, we directly do all the background process.
Okay.
Avoiding the scanning operation.
Okay, I think the calling process is over the runtime is over, I think, the Java file.
Yeah, yeah. So that is another thing. And okay. Also, if you have multiple kind of configuration, if you put it in XML, it is the code readability is also very bad actually. So if you put it in Java, it will be very easy.
Okay, fine.
So hereafter, you should not use what? XML.
Okay.
Use all the Java files alone.
Okay. So why you are saying every time it's a Java file, you can use the annotation base. I think these two things are different.
What annotation?
I mean, because we are saying every time instead of using the XML, we will going to use the annotation base.
Okay. But annotation is actually we are using in Java file, right? So like app config, dispatcher config like that.
Okay.
You can take it. Okay. We'll use instead of XML, you use Java annotation. Okay.
Okay.
Now we are going to, so we have created one application, right?
All right.
First, what is the first home page of that application? It will ask for the topic. Now we are going to secure this with the help of Spring Security.
Okay.
What today we are going to see is, today we are not going to create any before that we will talk about Spring Security. So Spring Security provides authentication and authorization.
Okay.
What is authentication?
So who will be to access a particular URL, particular page and all those, that is authentication.
then what is meant by authorization?
Okay, it should be different. I actually am confused all those terms.
Okay, authentication means simply you can say that, for example, the login page is an authentication, right? Mm. Authorization means in some web application, what happened is some kind of resource will be hidden for some kind of roles. For example, if you go for a banking application, actually they have a single application only. Some kind of thing will be hidden for the general user. Some kind of thing will be hidden by the bank manager. Some kind of the thing will be hidden by some kind of thing. So we'll see that actually. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So authentication, it deals with who can authorize, like with the help of login kind of thing. Authorization means what kind of access they will have, access to that particular resources. We can restrict the access kind of thing.
Okay.
Okay. So the Spring Security provides this both authentication and authorization.
Okay.
So by default, it provides a default authorization. Okay. First, we will just check. Sorry, a default authentication. Okay. So default login page we are going to create with the help of Spring.
Okay.
So for that, go to pom.xml. Go to pom.xml. We have to add one more dependency.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Actually, we need to add three dependency. Mm-hmm. The first dependency is org.springframework.security. Yeah. And the thing is, we are going to provide a security for the web. So you just type web. Yeah. You just select that. Okay, select some version. Okay, again you have to create one more thing. We are going to provide a security for the configuration files also. So again, org.springframework.security. Then you type config the artifact.
Config?
Yeah. First, select the first one. Yeah. And what we are going to do is we can authorize. Actually, we will authentication and authorization can be done, right? For authorization, we will write some codes in JSP tag libraries. So we have to provide that also. So you again use org.springframework.security, and you just type J tag like that, tag libs. Yeah, select that. Okay. So now just save this. Okay.
What important?
So why we are using web security hyphen web?
We are applying this thing
because like to provide a CSRF, that is cross-site request forgery kind of prevention we can do with the help of security web. Then security config is nothing but what kind of login page we will use kind of thing. And tag lib is like, it's for authorization. Once we do some application, you can see like what is tag lib, what is config, what is web, like that. Okay.
Mm.
Now what we have to do is we have to create one more configuration file. Okay. So that configuration file is security configuration file.
Okay.
Go there, go in that configuration file, right click and select new Java class security config like that. Okay. Okay. So now what we have to do is we no need to write any logic here in this security config. We have to do just only one thing. We have to make sure that this class extends one more class. Okay. So you have to type extends abstract security web application initializer. That's it. You just save. Okay. Can you just run this?
No bin name, sipping security filter chain available.
Oh, okay. So we have to create one more thing actually.
Okay.
Go to the code. Go to the code and inside the config. Okay. So inside the config you have to create one more thing. Yeah. For example, right click that and select new. Create security, like security configuration, like that you type. Configuration, okay. Okay. Now this actually this file, we will write some authentication and authorization kind of thing we will write in this class. Okay, this must be extends with web security configurer adapter. Web security configurer. Yeah, third one. Yeah. So this is actually a configuration file. So you have to put add configuration. At configuration, then actually you have to press enter and you have to type at enable web security. Enable web security. Okay, so I think now you can run them. Yeah, so by default when you enable that, it will give you a default authentication login page like this. Okay?
Where this code is wrote, written?
No, it will, by default it will call, it is not written actually, it will create an authentication page for us.
Mm-hmm.
We can modify this also for with our custom login page also. You can right click and you can select the view source code. Right click. What happened? What you did?
Nothing.
Right click somewhere in the page. Select. Yeah, this is done by the Spring itself. This kind of code will be done by the Spring itself. Okay. Now, how will you log in to this?
Always, I need the username and the password.
Username and the password. Go to the ID.
Mm-hmm.
It will have the password. It will have the encrypted password there.
Where it is?
It should show actually. Just go top. Little bit. Somewhere it should show. It will show. Come down. Not showing. Actually, first it will show the password. Can you give me the access? Can you give me? Hello?
visible for you?
Yeah, go to the ID. Okay. Somewhere it should show the password girl. Wait. Can you just give me the access?
Yeah, sure.
It will show the password, actually.
It's showing here JMX password and all that.
Yeah, go there.
It's here, but I don't know what was in character.
Okay. So wait. Actually, let me add one more code so that it will show. Where is the configure? Is that showing any password now? No. Okay, so we'll add actually. In Spring Boot, it will automatically show, but I think here we have to add.
Left one.
Okay. Spring Boot, what it will do is it will give you the password also, but let me just try. So first you have to create a user, okay? So using something called user builder. Actually, this is manual way of doing. Actually, we are tomorrow we are going to create username and password in the database, and we are going to do that. Actually, this is deprecated. We'll just try. So in memory authentication dot with user us dot username Anita. Dot password Anita. I think now you have to type username and password as Anita to log into the site. So tomorrow what we will do is we will create that in database, and based on that it will fetch and it will give access. Okay. Is your system become slow or what?
I don't know.
Hey, wait. It'll take some time. Is that finished?
It's saying it's finished.
No, I think best you can restart this. Stop and restart.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, start it. What happened? Close this one.
Cannot pass a null granted authority.
Okay. So you have to give roles also. Sorry, I forgot. You close that. Just after password Anita, you just put dot. Yeah, dot roles. Yeah, roles. You just put in double quotes manager in caps. In capital letter. Yeah. Okay, so now I think it will work. Yeah, type Anita. Login, click on that. Yeah, now it's working. Now actually, yeah, it's working, right? Now you can put slash, go there and slash, type slash display kind of thing. Yeah, it's working, right?
Shall I do something after the login? It just directly go to display.
Yeah. Go to the controller and you just modify that.
Yes, home controller.
Yeah, home controller. You just delete that slash display. Yeah, that's it. It will automatically go to the Spring Security. Right.
Okay.
Yeah. Now you, what you do is you try to, you can't able to access that actually without login. Right. So that is, if it allow us to do all this thing, then it is said to be a CSRF, cross site request forgery. Right.
What?
So what I'm trying to tell is, for example, you just change the controller as, go there, change the controller as, for example, display slash display.
Name of the controller you want to change?
No, not name, in the request mapping, instead of forward slash you put forward slash display, not here, below girl,
on the method name.
Yeah. Now normally how will you call this controller, how will you call this method? You will put slash display, right? So localhost colon 8080 slash display kind of thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now try to call that slash display. So don't log in, just delete that login, login and try to type display. Yeah. So this is the thing. So so this is called a CSRF. Like if you, even though if you want to fetch some resources inside that, if you have a link, okay, if you can able to access, then it is said to be a CSRF. So this Spring Security will disable that CSRF. Can you understand now?
CSRF, full form of CSRF?
Cross-site request forgery.
Okay.
Can you understand that? Because you are going to use the resource called slash display.
Display, okay? Yeah.
But whenever you type slash display there, it will use, it is used, it is asked for the authentication, right?
Right.
Yeah, so that is preventing CSRF.
Okay.
So today what we discussed is, today we have created all, we have converted the classical XML file into a Java-based file, right?
Right.
Then we provided a standard default security mechanism. We have not created any login pages. We just used the predefined login page, which is used by Spring Security.
But and I want to use my.
What?
I want to use my login page, and then it will be all those things.
So for that, we will do it tomorrow because it will take another 2 hours.
Okay.
We have to create a database, then we have to map all the database because we are not going to use hibernate.cfg.xml. We are going to write that as a Java file.
Mm-hmm.
So then we have to map that database with this thing. Because here we are using Anita as a in-memory user and password.
Mm-hmm.
So this is called as in-memory authentication. Now we will do, so next we will do a authentication with the help of the database.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll create some roles, for example, Anita as manager and Arul Suju as employee kind of thing. Anita will have certain resources to be viewed only by Anita. Similarly, the employee, I will be restricted with some access, right?
Right.
Kind of thing we will do tomorrow maybe, because tomorrow I have meeting. But after meeting,